Let me see if I have a count here on video. 6, 97, 98, 99, 100. 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107. So 107 plus whatever else we pull off the field is the count. Matt's taking down this field with a disc bind. This is some thick, heavy hay. Wow. I bet we get 100 bales off of this field alone. There's 20-something acres here. I think it's going to be about 25 acres all said and done. But this is as thick as I've ever seen it. And I'm sort of at the hilltop, so it's hard to see how it kind of dips over the hill and sort of pans out into a valley. But that's a big John Deere, so that'll give you a clue on how big this field is. He's in the mud. That's it. He's gonna have to back out of that. There is a lot of hay down in this field. I'm going to easily guesstimate over 100 bales in this field alone. Keter bear. Never heard of it before, but this was that Keter that I fetched out of a farm way very north at the edge of New York State bordering Canada, and brought it down with the Clampett truck. We call the GMC one ton dually our Clampett truck, not to offend anybody, but I think most people will get the joke. And this damn thing works excellent. Just tedded out this field right here, and I think the hay's about ready to go anyway. But it looks good and smells good. That's usually a good sign. Get the timothy in here, you know, orchard grass. That thing's just awesome. That has saved me hours and hours and hours. And one of the things that happens is we get a lot of moisture, a lot of rain. And by tedding out the hay, you can get it to dry a lot faster, quite a bit faster. And that's what's happened, you know. Put that thing on it and it takes about a day out of the drying cycle versus just letting it sit down on the ground and try to dry out. But very, very pleased with that purchase. A few little dings, you know, it's an old machine, but in general it works really well. Well, another year has gone by in my old stuff here. My old tractor and my old baler has done another, let me think, 160, 120, 280 plus 50. 320 on the first cutting, which really isn't bad. And I had to replace one bearing. I did break the haybine. I have to do some welding on it. We have a smooth rolling roller right there. Now the next trick is to get it back on the machine. I've got one ram that opens that door on the baler that needs to get repacked and resealed, but for the most part it was event free. That's just first cutting, but that's taking care of all the hay that I have to have for myself.